Brian's life wasn't always about gunfights and butt plugs. Years before the legendary Southend Underwater Bare Knuckle Championship, before the misadventures of an ambitious Brian unfolded in the chaotic streets of Essex in the 90s. If you thought Brian was hungry then, you have no idea how hungry Brian was back in the 80s. Before the drugs, the money, the fast cars and the women, an entrepreneurial Brian L had his sights set on a grander stage. A land of sun-soaked shores and untapped criminal opportunities. Years before any of it, there was Marbella.
Police say they've seized 32 tons of hashish. Drugs with a street value of around 50 million euros were found in the back of a refrigerated truck carrying melons from Morocco.
In the shadows of Marbella's towering palm trees, Brian's hunger for success burned brightly. He saw the potential for greatness amidst the lavish lifestyles and hidden secrets of this Mediterranean paradise. Driven by his insatiable hunger for success, Brian embarked on a journey to become a drug smuggler, hoping to carve his name into the Hall of Fame of criminal history. But little does he know that the treacherous path ahead is paved with pitfalls and comedic calamities. For Marbella was no ordinary playground, it was a battleground of ambition and betrayal, where fortunes were won and lost with a single stroke of a pen or the squeeze of a trigger. Brian quickly learned that survival in this realm required not only cunning, but nerves of steel. If stupidity was an Olympic sport, Brian would take the gold, silver and bronze home.
Than I've ever been arrested. You know, that's saying something good, mate.
Big up Essex Police. The light. I'll put a statement against you tonight, Del Boy. You muggy, bald cunt. You're getting raided, and your site's getting raided, and your yard. Deal with that.
With his trademark optimism and unwavering confidence, Brian wastes no time on Spanish soil, his delusions of grandeur propelling him forward. He believes that within the vibrant tapestry of this foreign land, his dreams of criminal glory will finally be realised. His relentless drive and unwavering determination, Brian immersed himself in the cutthroat world of Marbella's criminal underworld. However, as Brian delves deeper into the underworld, his lack of experience and comically inept nature become apparent. With his uncanny ability to make the simplest of tasks into a disaster, time and again, he finds himself stumbling from one misadventure to another.
Now, Plisco, someone's moving me up. I'm on you, Plisco. Trust me. My life is dedicated to your two sons, Plisco. I'm going to bring
my two sons
and Fury, your two sons. Trust me on this.
I'll get five sons.
You don't see the other three. You don't see them. You're going to see hell break loose on your sons. Trust me.
I tell you what, Brian. Since you're nice and in shape now, right, why don't you come down to Torquay?
I've got your picture.
From misinterpreted conversations to botched transactions, Brian's attempts at becoming a successful drug exporter become a never-ending series of embarrassments. He's a fish out of water, navigating the treacherous currents of the criminal underworld with all the finesse of a toddler learning how to walk. As Brian's misadventures unfold against the backdrop of 1980s Spain, the land of flamenco and fiestas, his dreams of criminal glory fade further into the realm of impossibility. Yet, his indomitable spirit refuses to yield, and he remains determined to leave his mark, no matter how comically disastrous the journey. Join Brian Hurl on the roller coaster ride through the sun-drenched streets of Spain as he stumbles and bumbles his way through the world of drug smuggling, leaving a trail of laughter in his wake. Get ready for the uproarious sequel that proves true gangster glory is not for the faint-hearted. Prepare yourself for a gripping tale of ambition, betrayal, sex and drugs, butt plugs, transvestites and everything in between. Witness the rise of Brian Hurl in Marbella's Web of Shadows.